Hello, in this video I'm going to introduce the EDEM API, the Applications Programming Interface. If you're interested in an overview of the standard capabilities of EDEM, please see our e-learning material. In this case, I'm going to introduce how the API plugs in to the Creator Simulation Analyst of EDEM. There's different programming languages that are available in EDEM. The API is mostly in C or C++, and we'll also introduce CUDA for GPU processing. CUDA is NVIDIA GPU only, very similar to the C format. There's also a legacy OpenCL, but I'm not going to introduce this. And I'm going to go through an example today. With the API, you can customize the plugin factories, the plugin contact models, and external forces. So I'm going to go through a tutorial outlining adding in external forces. So starting off, I'll go to the Altair community site and download the API tutorial materials. These come in a zip file, unzip, and we can see they've got the example files and some source material. Opening up this EDEM example, we can see it's an intersection here, and if I run the simulation, nothing really happens. We have we'll have some particles created at the base here, but gravity pulls them down. So if I go to the physics section, field data manager, we can import a field, in this case a CGNS field, and it comes in with a temperature and a velocity field. This has been exported from a CFD package. I'm going to delete the temperature field and just leave the velocity vector field in this case. So we can display the field and see the velocity vectors outlined in EDEM. Going to the particle body force, which is where we apply a force to the particles based on this field, you can see that there's no physics available, nothing set for this. So what I'm going to do is go to create a physics model for it, starting with Visual Studio. It's the Microsoft tool used to compile. If I go to create a new project, empty project, and just put the name and location of my project in. The tutorial files come with some existing files, so I'm just copying these files into the same folder as the Visual Studio project. Then go to header files, add existing item, and add in the header, the .h file, and the same for the source files. So add existing item, add in the source files. The C field query, the CPP is the main file, and I can see here that there's a few errors already, cannot find these associated include files. If we go to the EDEM install folder, in this case 2022.1 EDEM source, you can see there's API files and there's contact models, there's core, there's particle body force. If we go to the core, we can copy this location and reference this in Visual Studio. So under properties, C++ additional include directories. I can paste the directory there, as well as the core files which we need for every project. This is a particle body force, so we will include the particle body force files. And also there are some miscellaneous helper files that's good to include in every project, so we will include those as well. I'm also going to take the opportunity while I'm in the property page to change from an EXE to a DLL. This is what we need to load into to EDEM. Now the set of errors have been resolved. I'll just change to 64-bit, but leave as a debug. For now, we can change to release, which would be faster. So we have some header files, the field query CPP, which includes the versioning. This is version 3.1 of the API. And we'll go to the main file here. First off, it references a text file. And that text file reads in these two parameters called density and viscosity. This is the text file which it references, and we can see we've got some values in there. This is just to say this is a mechanism for reading in external files into EDEM. Then we'll go to the external force function, and this is information that EDEM is providing and expecting in return some results, typically the force and the torque. So let's maybe get straight into the kind of the physics of this, the equations. First off, creating some empty variables for CFD field, calculating the radius from the particle volume, calculate the cross-sectional area from the radius pi r squared, define a gravity vector, and then calculate the buoyancy forces from the gravity, particle volume, and the density, and applying that buoyancy to a field force. Then there's some blank spaces here which we're adding in particle position. So this is querying a vector field, position x, position y, and position z. These are the positions of the particles. And what's happening here is that we're querying the vector field and then taking 8 points around the particle position, doing an inverse distance weighting and returning the CFD field x, y, and z velocities from this. We want to convert that CFD field that's been returned into a vector. So we'll return this as x, y, and z components to CFD field. We then want to query the particle velocity. So particle.velocity.getx. And the same for y and z, and we'll put this in a vector format. Then we want to calculate the relative velocity between the particle and the fluid. So we'll take the fluid vector. And this is where the EDEM helper files help out. It's just the functions are all kind of set up to do this for us. The Reynolds equation has already been written in. We have the density, the velocity, the diameter, and the viscosity. And from that, we can work out the drag coefficient. Then we want to calculate the drag force. This could be any force really that you want to apply any kind of equation. In this case, it's a relatively straightforward free stream drag equation. Relative velocity multiplied by 0.5 multiplied by the drag coefficient. Cross-sectional area of the particle, the diameter. The density and the relative velocity, length of the vector, the magnitude. We then return the total force to this field force, which you calculated earlier and added the buoyancy to it. And then we're adding that to the results.force, and we can build this project, and we can see it's created an API example.dll, and it's placed it in this location here. So if I go to the example, copy the DLL into the same folder as the EDEM simulation. Also, we have the text file which contains the density and the viscosity of the fluid, which gets read in as well. We can then open our simulation and go to the particle body force and add the API example in there. So we can see that it's given a couple of errors. Initially, it said versioning is 3.1, and the plugin is not ready to start processing. In terms of the versioning, the versioning can be updated in a later version of the software. However, the plugin is not ready to start processing is something more critical which we need to address. If we go to the functions, we have the external force function, which is the main function, there's a starting function as well. We can see here we're reading the field data manager, or loading the field data manager, and from the field data manager we're loading a field. It has a field data name. Field data name in this case is cfd_field. Now if we go back to our field we imported, you can see it's actually named velocity, so changing the name allows us then to run the simulation. It's still going to give an error regarding the API models been slightly older. This means that in some versions of the API we can take the contact model forces and return it to the particle body force. In this case they're separate separate forces. Thank you for listening. I hope the introduction to the API was useful. I'm going to create another video just to highlight how to update API versions, and then when you have the latest API version we can introduce how we convert the API to run on CUDA, GPU as well as CPU.